really want to do a smart embedded vision design. All the cool engineers are doing it these days. My camera needs to do a lot more than just stream a video signal. It needs to see the world, understand it. So let's see. I need a camera, of course, and a display so I can see what's going on, and some kind of processor, and an FPGA doing some AI inference and connecting all that stuff together so those things can actually talk to each other, and phew, just getting started on this thing is going to be tough and expensive. Hi, I'm Amelia Dalton, host of Chalk Talk. Getting started on an FPGA-based embedded vision system is a pretty tricky task. What we need is a dev kit that has all the right stuff, all working together. And that doesn't cost an arm and a leg. My guest today is Avery Williams from Microchip Technology, and we're going to dive into the Hello FPGA Evaluation and Development Kit. Let's go. And before we get started, don't forget to click that link. There you can find even more information about Microchip Technology's Hello FPGA Evaluation Kit. Hi, Avery. Thank you so much for joining me.
Hey, Amelia. I'm happy to be here. Thanks for having me.
So let's say I'm new to FPGAs and I'm designing an embedded vision system or something where I want to do a lot of processing on a video signal. Now, the FPGA part is scary for a lot of people, right?
Okay, so we know that new customers are going to have a range of knowledge when it comes to FPGAs. There's going to be people that have been doing FPGAs their whole lives, and there's going to be people that never worked with FPGAs. So we wanted to design a low-cost kit for those people with low to medium knowledge on FPGAs, because we want to make their transition into the FPGA world as smooth as possible, because we know FPGAs can be scary. So we designed a kit. We put in our Smart Fusion 2 SoC FPGA, and we're excited about the capabilities that this kit can do.
Cool. Okay, so what all comes in this Hello FPGA kit?
Okay, starting with the FPGA main board, that's going to be where you have your Smart Fusion 2 SoC. Then we go to the camera board that is going to handle all the video streaming. And finally, we have the display board so you can look at what's going on in the back of the kit. All of that rolled into one, you're going to get your Hello FPGA kit. And with this kit, you're going to be able to do cool demos and image processing, signal processing, and artificial intelligence. And as people get more comfortable with our tools, we've even added Arduino and microbus connectors so people can prototype, use expansion kits, and really utilize this development platform.
Okay, so all the main pieces I need to get started. But Avery, tell me more about this Smart Fusion 2 FPGA that's inside.
Okay, so the Smart Fusion 2 FPGA is a part of our Generation 4, and we consider our Generation 4 group of FPGAs low density, but we consider them low density with more resources. So those more resources are going to come into the shape of high-speed serial interfaces with a 5 gigabit SerDes, or high-speed memory interfaces with DDR2 and DDR3 controllers. And we've even added an ARM Cortex M3 hard-embedded processor into the Smart Fusion 2 SoC to help with some of those processing capabilities.
Okay, I'm intrigued. Let's dive down into this FPGA part.
Looking at this architecture, in the middle, we're going to have our FPGA fabric. That's going to be the orange box. That's where you're going to have your embedded memory blocks, your math blocks that are going to scale with the device family. And on the bottom, you're going to see where those transceivers I was talking about, the 5 gigabit SerDes. So on Smart Fusion 2, all the device families are going to have the SerDes except for our smallest density. Moving off that to the upper left-hand corner, you're going to see our system controller. And this is where you're going to see our security features that this device has to offer. Finally, we're going to talk about the microcontroller subsystem. And this is where the ARM Cortex M3 is going to be. And you're also going to get that DDR controller I mentioned, the USB on the go, and built-in secure flash. So as I mentioned earlier, this is really going to be a low-density FPGA with more resources.
Okay, so Avery, it seems like we have a demo. Why don't you walk me through this?
So for the very first demo, it's going to be a digital signal processing application. So a FIR and FFT filter. So on the first tab, you're really going to set up your filter by being able to choose your filter type, your cutoff frequency, and generate your input signal. After that is generated, you're going to be able to go into your filter input and actually see what your input signal looks like before it's filtered. Once you press start, your filtered coefficients and your input signal are going to be sent to the FPGA, and the FPGA is going to process it, sending you the FIR output signal after it's been generated. And we've even added a feature for the people that like to see the numbers and not the graph to view the input signal, filter coefficients, and output signal all in text format under the text viewer tab.
Okay, so Avery, let's say I want to do your basic image processing design, nothing fancy. What can you do for me here?
So we actually have a image processing demo, and it starts out with a camera sending the 640 by 480 with 8-bit parallel interface and sync signals to the FPGA, and the FPGA is then going to scale down that 640 by 480 video into 480 by 320 to match the resolution of the LCD screen by skipping pixels and skipping horizontal lines. But using the image enhancement module that we have, you're going to be able to control the brightness, control the contrast, control the color balance using on-chip multipliers in the FPGA.
Okay, cool. So what else have you got?
Saving certainly the best for last is the artificial intelligence digit recognition demo. Now, going into this demo, it's a similar process of scaling down the video from the camera, but now it's scaling down to a 28 by 28 input to the convolution neural network. And a convolution neural network consists of a series of layers where the output of each layer acts as an input to the next layer. So you're going to have four convolution layers, but you're also going to have a max pool layer. And this max pool layer is going to reduce the amount of data that's passed to the next layer. And the last layer is going to be a fully connected output layer. This last output layer is going to use the data to match with the 10 built-in classes. And with that data, it's going to map out which number has the highest probability of relating to this data. And that is how you're going to get your digit recognition number. And all of this is happening in real time. That's why you do need that FPGA parallel processing. And that's where the hardened ARM Cortex M3 processor comes in handy to help offload some of these processing applications.
Okay, Avery, so how do I know what my power consumption is like?
We do have a tab that lets you monitor what your actual power consumption is, so you can see how low our power consumption and when these designs are running. And we even have the capability to enable and disable our flash freeze mode. Now, for those of you that don't know what flash freeze mode is, that allows you to maintain your registers and your memory state and essentially go into a standby mode. Now, one of the coolest things about the standby mode and with this kit is you can disable and enable it with the click of a button. So you can see how fast the actual design wakes up from the standby mode. My favorite demo to do this with is an image processing demo, because when you enter into this flash freeze mode, it's going to sort of take the image that was last on the video stream and just hold it there. And as soon as you hit that exit flash freeze mode, it goes immediately in real time to real-time video.
Okay, Avery, so how do I get my bitstream into the FPGA?
So as people get more comfortable with our tools, we expect them to want to expand and develop, and that's going to mean programming. So you really have two different options when it comes to programming Smart Fusion 2. You can use the external JTAG with a Flash Pro 5 or 4, or you can program from the PIC32. Now, with the PIC32 method, that's where you're going to be able to import your file into the GUI and run the programming features from the GUI. And that's going to directly program the Smart Fusion 2 FPGA. These are the different ways that you can program and expand on your Hello FPGA kit.
All right. Well, I think that's all I have time for today. I'm going to click that link and go to amouser.com site for more information. Well, Avery, it was a pleasure speaking with you. Thank you so much for joining me.
Thank you for having me. It's been as fun as always.
And before we go, you didn't forget to click that link, did you? There you can find even more information about Microchip Technologies' Hello FPGA Evaluation Kit. For Chalk Talks, I'm Amelia Dalton from eejournal.com. For more Chalk Talks, head on over to the Chalk Talk section of EE Journal. You can't miss it. It's right across the top. Or head on over to YouTube, youtube.com/EEJournal.